Hi everyone, Nick here. Boris Effect Sapphire 2025 has just been released, and with it we have a brand new transition, Light Leak Dissolve. I'll show you how to make the most of this effect for your footage and your scenes. Let's dive right in. Okay, so I'm here inside of Premiere Pro, and I'll just play back the outcoming and incoming clip that I would like to add the Light Leak Dissolve to. In order to do that, I'm going to head over to my Effects tab. And if we head into Video Transitions, you're going to see all the Sapphire transitions located in the corresponding folder. I'll drag the S-Dissolve Light Leak onto the edit point of my two clips and just center my playhead over that. Let's head into Effect Controls and get familiar with what's possible with this effect by loading a preset. I'll press Shift 5. We'll load a preset. Now that we're inside, we can easily click between the various presets. But in addition to that, if I select Blue Streak and just press the play button, you can see here that you're able to preview the outgoing and incoming clip. All controls over your view of what you're seeing here in the screen, the source clips that you've brought over from Premiere Pro, or if you want to do it on black, you've got a ton of options here, not to mention in playback. Let's hop back to default in terms of the transition that we're going to use and become familiar with just a couple parameters. So I'll load that into Premiere Pro. And with most Sapphire effects, the most important controls happen to be at the top. Since I'm on the height of the transition, let's first of all go to the transition brightness, which we can easily bring down depending on the colors or luminance. And I think one of the most important controls here is the scale mode. This controls how the light leaks comes in and out with the dissolve. To get a better sense for this, I'm actually going to bring down the element max size to be quite small, in this case just 0.4. And let's also bring down the minimum size to 0.2. So we can start to see the outer regions of the elements that make up the light leak, but more importantly, how this is going to animate in and out. So now that this is smaller, you'll notice the transition scale mode is set to size up. Let's loop playback here in the program monitor, and I'm just going to draw a quick in and out point. So now if I use the hotkey, which is Option K, we get to see that transition play back. And clearly that this light leak is sizing up. If we change that to size down, now we can see that it starts at the actual element max size and goes down to the min size. Or we have a mixture of both. It scales up to its max value and then down to its minimum value. Having control over this scale mode directly affects how the feel of your light leak is going to be, not to mention along with other parameters. Now that we've covered those basics, I'll just reset these parameters. Okay, let's see that first example full frame. I'll bring up another example here where we can again see the outgoing and incoming clip. And I'll apply a light leak from that transition category again and center my playhead over the light leak. Let's press Shift 5 to take a look at this. In this instance, I just want to reveal that if you select the effect at the top, we have these on-screen controls. It just so happens that your light leak is made of several elements, three, and by default, two are turned on. These on-screen controls allow you to affect those elements. And it's always best to just start with one. So I'm going to turn off element two so we can clearly see element one. You'll see that I'm affecting the center XY of the light leak, not to mention if I drag the oval, the size of the light leak. We get to now own in on the actual colors of the light leak, which are a mixture of the center, mid, and outer colors. I'm going to switch these up to some different colors, not to mention if we played around with the softness, the change of blend between those colors, not to mention bringing down the size so you could see the effect of the outer band. So changing this changes the element, and just above the element, or the three elements, are the overall controls, which change the way that all three of them, if they were active, will play together. So in instance, if I come around here and adjust the hue saturation, that's going to affect the hue saturation of the three colors involved in element one. In addition, I could just add an overall color overlay to all of the three colors underneath to get a desired look, depending on how I like to work. It's really important that with the overall controls of your light leak, that you can mix in other animation elements besides the scale mode. That includes adding a speed to your light leaks, which I'll bring up to 1.5. So I'm going to adjust the flicker amplitude, which affects how much, and then the flicker frequency, which affects how often. And let's take a look at how this frequency amount could affect different variations of light leaks. So there you have it, taking you through some of the basics of Dissolve Light Leak inside of Sapphire 2025. For more tips and tricks just like this, don't forget to subscribe and check us out at borisfx.com.